Hi, welcome to the basic introduction video series on creating Bluetooth low energy and wireless LAN tests with Keysight X8711A IoT device functional test solution. This series of video will demonstrate the basic steps involved in making a test program using instrument driver in both C# and LabView programming platforms. And in this episode, the first episode of the series, I will provide an overview of the programming flow. The X8711A test solution helps to streamline the functional test processes of a wireless-enabled IoT devices. It establishes the radio link connection with the DUT in normal operation mode and enables the physical layer measurement. The over-the-air RF test and verification can be easily set up by adding an antenna coupler and shoebox to the solution. Engineers can immediately test a wireless-enabled DUT that works in normal operation with the X8711A without the needs in developing chipset control. This would reduce the development and production test time tremendously and accelerate the product's time to the market. The X8711A is built on the Keysight 34972A, which is a popular small footprint 3-slot mainframe, and Keysight 34998A RF module is slotted into the mainframe. It supports Bluetooth Low Energy 4.2 and Wireless LAN 2.4GHz signaling tests and could be scaled up to include other IoT wireless technologies in the future. The 34998A RF module is connected to a PC for automation tests using the ready test program that is built based on the Keysight tab platform and measurement suites. Or you could develop your test program to automate the testing using the 34998A driver. It is a .NET DLL programming interface and can be installed through the X8711A install wizard. In this video, I will show you the 5 basic steps in making a test program using the 34998A driver to perform the receiver packet error rate and transmitter power measurement. The procedure started with the reference of 34998A driver DLL to a program created in the integrated development environment that you are using. Install the driver DLL from the X8711A install wizard, which is downloadable from the URL link as shown on the screen. Once you have the 34998A driver installed, the driver DLL is located in the directory of your PC as shown on the screen. The program begins with the creation of the instrument session. This is a mandatory step to establish a communication link with 34972A and 34998A before you could send instruction or receiving the data from the instrument. Once the instrument connection is established, we can start setting up the system in signaling mode and configure the test parameter of the measurements to be performed in the next step. For example, the DL power level for receiver PR test, or the frequency channel and trigger level for transmitter power output measurement. At this step, you could start making the signaling link with the DUT and execute the RF measurements and get the result. In receiver PR measurement, the tester is tracking the response message from DUT to the request message sent from the tester. Any missing response message or the message is received with errors will be counted as back packet. As in transmitter output power measurement, the tester captures and measures the average power of the transmitter signal of the DUT during the normal scanning process. At the final step before ending or closing the program, this is always a good practice to properly disconnect the communication link with the instrument and release the driver handle to free up the memory space used by the driver DLL. Step 1, 2, and 5 must be performed if the PC or the instrument is power cycled. Step 3 and 4 can be repeated as many times as required for a full test sequence of the measurements to cover the chosen test plan for the device under test. It is advisable during the software test development or debugging to catch any potential exception due to the potential errors in the programming or setup. For example, The use of try-catch blocks in Microsoft Visual Studio .NET allows the program to catch any errors without the program aborting. Well, I hope you will find this video helpful. Please check out the next video in series that will demonstrate the programming steps using C# or LabView. Thank you for watching and for choosing Keysight.